How we know that we are loved? How we know that? What is the key for us to know that we are loved? The sisters have the experience. How do you know that you are loved?
I'm here.
You are here. Okay, that is great. You are here. This is a beautiful, beautiful gospel. And we need to ask ourselves how we really know that we are loved. Because sometimes our faith could be a faith of knowledge with a lack of love. And that is why life sometimes become a little bit tough because of the absence of the feeling of the one who called us to embrace the religious life. The essence of the religious life is the power of Jesus Christ through his love. That is the essence, to be able to say yes. The essence to be able to say yes is that love. And love is something that always, you know, we see in ads, in TV, who sell different products that you can wear, put, use, drink, take it, who will give you the eternal youth. No wrinkles, nothing. You see that ads in TV. And we say, wow, may I have something to keep young? What is not truth? What is the key for the eternal youth? Is the joy of the heart when it is loved. And that is the key for keep our vocation and to keep your vocation always strong, joyful, and to deal with one another. Be patient with one another. And that is tough. We are not patient too much sometimes. But how we learn, and how we learn in life, the measure of love that Jesus is talking today, you need to love one another, not with my conditions. That is the problem in our lives, that I like to be loved in my way. And that is why sometimes love is not enough. Jesus said, love one another as I love you. That is the measure in which we are called to live our vocation, your religious life, my priesthood. And that is why we always need to be open to be loved in the way that Jesus loved us. How much he loved me. How patient Jesus is with me. To be patient with another one, first I need to sit down and think, how patient is God with me? If we see that, we will be in awe. Dealing with me every day, God. That is when we recognize that he's God and he loves us. And when we see the mercy that is coming through his love, dealing with us in our daily lives, dealing with each one of us in our daily lives, is when we start to see every day more clear what true love means and start to apply and live that in practice in our daily lives. That is the key. And how we know that? Well, The people who fell in love, they fell in love because they date. They have ways to date and make a time to be together. I'm going for a dinner, going for a walk, holding hands, smile to each other. That is beautiful. But that is the key for us, how we date with Jesus. That is one thing. Sometimes we say we pray. Yeah, but when say we pray, it's like something, we don't know where. Pray the bravery, yeah, it's fine, it's beautiful, it's needed. But beyond of that is the call for us to date with Jesus. Make that time when you can be and we can be with him, holding hand with him. Let him to hold your hand. Let him to embrace you. Let him to kiss you. Let him to listen the silence of your heart. Let him to dry the tears of your eyes. Let him to smile, to draw a beautiful smile in your face. And that only happens when we make time to date with him. That time who is private, who is only with him and me alone. Mwah. It's perfect, it's beautiful. Because Jesus is there waiting for us to be free, to let him to come, to transform us. And that is the most beautiful medicine, cream, pill, to transform us, to transform us with the eternal youth. That is the joy of our hearts. Religious life, you're 65, and you have plenty of time to keep falling in love. That is the key. In the religious life, that is the key. How we keep falling in love. We go down with the one who loves us. If there's no way today to fall more in love with him, something is wrong. And sometimes we can say, I don't feel that. I don't feel nothing. Yes, you're feeling something, the emptiness sometimes of that love. And that is love. How your own heart is telling you how important is love in our lives. It's silence, but the silence is calling you to cry out and louder for that love. Every moment in our lives are calling us to renew in our own hearts our relationship with the one who loves us. Date with him. We need to taste how wonderful, how new, how special, and how great is his love every day. Because love is new every day. Because Jesus is new every day. And that is why we need to date, to make time, to be with him, to discover today the newness of that love in Jesus Christ. And to measure the way that we love as Jesus told us today. Love one another as I love you. Not in the way that I want to love you. No. Have the freedom to let him to be in charge. Not only for the religious life, for all of us. Because all of us We need to experience love to make sense to the things of our lives. All of us, we are calling to make time to be with the one who loves us. We say sometimes, oh, I don't have time today to pray because I'm so busy. But we don't have any problems to sit down in front of the TV watching all news, all games, all programs there for 1 hour, 2 hours, 3 hours. And at the end say, oh, Lord, I'm very tired, the Father, the Son. Three hours in adoration in front of the TV. And we don't have time to taste, see, and experience love. The key to say yes every day to respond to the vocation of your religious life or our priestly life. We continue this celebration giving thanks to God because He's waiting to let us know that His love is always new every day. And as the Pope Francis says, let Jesus surprise you today. And we need to have our eyes very open to see what is there to let Him to surprise us.